Hi there. So today we're going to take a look at all of the components that will come in your stem.t4L 3D printing kit. We're going to unbox the equipment and take a really close look at all of the things that you should expect to find inside of your 3D printer kit. So let's have a bit of a look at what comes in the box. You will receive two kits in your school that look somewhat like this. There will be two large boxes, and inside each box should be all of these components that are familiar to the 3D printing kit. So let's take a look inside. As I open it up, there are a few things that we'll find in here that become quite obvious. The first thing that we will find is a laptop. Now, the laptop is a laptop that is set up in a way that is designed for your 3D printer, and it has all of the appropriate software on it. When we open it up, you'll see that this is a school-based laptop, and you log into it on your usual DET New South Wales Wi-Fi system, and your students will be able to access any appropriate software that they require. Let's put that one aside and have a look at what else is in the box. Now, the next big, most obvious thing is actually our 3D printer. So let's reach in and take that out. Now, the 3D printer itself will most likely have some of the parts for it inside the 3D printer. If they're not located inside the 3D printer, they may actually be in the box somewhere as well. But it's a pretty convenient place to put some of the parts. So I can see inside of this one at the moment, I have a few bits and pieces. I have a power cord, I have a couple of little clips and things, and I also have the lid that goes on top of my 3D printer. So let's reach in and take it out. There are two ways that I could take it out. I can either reach in and try and angle it out from the top, but if you find that your print head is in an inconvenient location, you can open the door at the front of the 3D printer and take it out via that method. I'm going to take it out from the top, so I'm simply going to reach in. I'm actually going to take out some of the power cords and other things first so they don't fall down. So in here I can see that I've got a power supply for the 3D printer, and I'm going to put that aside. When I reach in, I can also find the hose that will attach my filament to my print head, and we're going to talk about the process of setting that up in a later video. So I'm also going to put that one aside. Now, as I reach in and I pull out the lid for my 3D printer, get it at the correct angle, we can now see that the lid for the 3D printer, which will clip onto the top, is something that should be stored inside the 3D printer. So I'm also going to put that one aside. Now, another thing that you will find inside of your 3D printer kit are a range of different tools and other components. But let's talk to some of the other components first. Inside my kit, I can also find a power supply for the laptop. Now, that may be located inside one of the other toolboxes, or even possibly inside of the 3D printer itself. Also in our kit, we are likely to find some additional 3D plastic. Now, the 3D printer plastic that is included with the 3D printer kit is the appropriate plastic for your 3D printer. It is PLA style plastic, which is a cornstarch derivative, which means that it will break down eventually. It will last around 25 to 30 years before it begins to break down, but it is a biodegradable plastic. It is 1.75 millimeters in diameter, and the color that we ship with the stem.t4L printers is white. All of the printers should come with a standard white plastic, and you'll get around 1 kilogram of plastic included with your kit. The reason why we ship it with white is because it is a standard color. You can see all of the details in the print, and white is very, very easy to paint and color for your students making more specific designs at a later stage. We are going to talk in another video as to how we actually load the plastic correctly into the 3D printer. So let's put that one aside as well. Now, the next thing that I'm going to talk to is our toolkit. Now, inside of the 3D printer, you will also likely find a toolkit that will look somewhat like this. It may not be in exactly this type of container, but you will find all of the appropriate tools. For any of this equipment that we're talking through, if you don't find one of the items, something to double check is make sure that it's not located in another compartment of the box. But if you're very sure that it's not there, there is a method that you can put in a request and we will make sure that those components are shipped out to your school. So let's take a look at what's inside this. Inside of this particular 3D printer toolkit, first thing that I'm noticing is that I have a USB cable. Now, that USB cable is designed to attach your laptop to your 3D printer. Now, that is one of the methods that you can use to 3D print, and we will talk to the methods of 3D printing in a later video, but you should find a USB cable. The other things that you will find inside of your toolkit include things like the appropriate adhesive spray that will go onto your print bed. Now, while I'm talking about the adhesive spray, I'm also now going to show you the print bed. And this is an important component because it matches with the conversation around this adhesive spray. What you may find when you begin your 3D print is the 3D print may begin and then it might start lifting or things might start actually not sticking to the print bed. The adhesive spray is not something you necessarily need to use all of the time, but if things start to lift, a few sprays of that adhesive spray and it will improve. The way that we would actually apply that is to open the front door of our 3D printer. I'm now going to reach inside, and on the inside of our 3D printer, you'll find that it has this little print tray. This print tray easily slides out of the front of our 3D printer. This one in particular is purple, yours may be blue, it may be another color. But that print tray simply slides out, and the print tray is where you would apply the adhesive spray if things were not sticking. A few things to consider around the details of our print bed. First thing is this surface area should be relatively smooth. And it can actually lift off fairly simply. It's magnetic. And when we lift it off the actual drawer itself, we can see that this little print bed is a piece of like spring steel, and it's quite flexible. So this print bed is able to be bent, which will allow you to sometimes just do a little pop or a little bend, which will allow a large print with a large surface area to remove some of the stickiness from the edge, and that will allow you to start getting things off. At which point, the scraper that comes included with your 3D printer kit can be used to kind of get underneath the corner of your 3D print to lift that 3D print away from the print bed. We simply reinstall this print bed by lining it up with the bottom of our 3D printer drawer, allowing the magnets to clip it back into place, and then we move back over to our 3D printer. We reach around to the front of our 3D printer, and it will very simply just slide back in to our 3D printer. Now, some of the other components that we're going to find in our toolbox included with our 3D printer. Some of these are, well, they're tools. Things like side cutters. Side cutters can become extremely useful for trimming away excess plastic, trimming away any scaffold, removing bits and pieces of plastic that may be hanging from the extrusion nozzle from your 3D printer. These become a very, very handy tool used predominantly by the teacher. But it's a tool that you will probably require at some point throughout your 3D printing journey. other things that are slightly less obvious as to why they're included. Let's take a look at some of the items that are in here. We have some Allen keys and some spanners and some more hardware type tools like screwdrivers for occasionally the need may arise to dismantle the print head in your 3D printer and clear any stuck plastic. Now, the analogy that I use for the stuck plastic is if you've ever had melted cheese or something like that, and plastic, when it melts the first time, it melts quite well. But if you try and melt it a second time, sometimes you might need to use some of these included tools to take some components off so that you can use things like the side cutters to then remove some of those excess pieces of plastic. Now, the least obvious things that come in the kit are things like this little butterfly piece of wire. And it's a little bit tricky to see, so I'm going to actually put it in the way of this background. And it's this thin butterfly piece of wire with kind of a T-shaped bend handle on the back of it. Now, what that is designed for is actually putting down through the extrusion nozzle from the top of your 3D printer and clearing out any excess of melted plastic. It is something that you are likely to use during your 3D printer journey in the period of time that you have borrowed the 3D printer from stem.t4l. Another item that you will find that's a very unusual item is a 3D nozzle little clearing implement. Now, I'm going to open it up and it's actually 3D printed. 3D printers are very interesting that they can make components for themselves. Now, this little 3D printed little nozzle is basically a handle that will allow us to then get one of these little pieces of spring wire that are also included. Now, those little pieces of spring wire, they're very, very hard to see on camera because they're very, very fine. And I've actually got two of them tangled together at the moment. Just need one of those. There is a small hole in the end of this little 3D printed component, and that will allow us to actually put that little spring into the end, and that little spring can then be used to clear any excess plastic that is caught within the very end of our 3D printing nozzle. Again, something that you are very likely to encounter the need for. I think the two most useful tools that you will find in this toolbox are actually your butterfly wire and this print nozzle clearer, because as we used the analogy before, when things melt for the first time, they melt quite easily, but as we get a little build up, those things can become a little hard, and these kinds of tools can then be used to clear those kind of blockages. And it does happen, it's quite common. And then grabbing things like your side cutters to then remove some of those components. Thank you for watching this video. If any of these components that we've discussed today are not included in your kit, please reach out to the stem.t4l team and we will make sure that all of the components that you require for your 3D printing journey at your school are all included in your kit.
This video is part of a series of support videos all about the kit that you have borrowed. To find the other videos in this series, head to the Learning Library and visit the kit page for the equipment you've borrowed. You can also find the full list of support videos for all of our kit on the YouTube channel. You can also join us in the Yammer community. If you have any questions or you'd like to ask teachers how they've used the equipment in their classroom, then why not join us on the STEMT4L Facebook community? It's a closed group, so you can ask teachers how they've used the equipment and also share the work samples that your students have created.